being hoisted. And then there's some sinister stuff. There's just a little bit of subtle in the black and white. I mean, is that pig dead?
Yeah, it looks like a dead pig.
Yeah, so there's, maybe it's a sleeping pig?
It's on a spit roast, but it's like, yeah, drool's coming out of it. It's kind of a weird panel.
And then there's a snake slithering.
Yeah.
Like, what is that? You know, there's, and then there's, I don't know, like, wait, the ominous.
And that those are in black and white, and that, like, there's a background of all this color music, but, yeah, the interplay of the black and white and the different levels of color and texture and cartoonishness.
It just evokes cool. different emotions from the viewer. I mean, I'm looking at this, and I'm just like, where is this? I mean, look at that. Like, you see so much when you look at it again. Look at that balloon guy in the clown just blowing a balloon.
And the fact there's no dialogue. The fact there's no dialogue just really starts laying all these hooks. It's like, okay, what is this guy doing here? Why does he not feel involved? What is everyone celebrating? Yeah.
Yeah. And then
we get to the next page, and it starts to organize a little bit more.
And they're celebrating him!
And our main character is, like, brought to... He's, like, put on these guys' shoulders, and then... He's taken somewhere. He's taken to, like, the sheriff or something.
What? It's nuts. What is it with the armadillo? He's just standing up armadillo on... And so there's a parade following this guy on the shoulders of the townspeople. And look at the reflection in the mirror. You can... Or in the window. That's detailed.
I didn't even notice that.
So much detail. And
it's next to like this sinister looking guy with a eye patch who we will see later.
And he's got a straight razor and he is the town barber, I imagine.
Yeah.
What's he doing there? And they're all heading. So
they draw attention to him, but they don't give him too much focus. You know, he has as much of a panel as that armadillo.
Yeah. and so they drag this guy to a pair of boots, and we meet the sheriff. And the sheriff is just so friendly looking, right?
Mm-hmm.
And this was a panel that I looked at for like a couple like beats, because the sheriff is the nicest guy in town. But when he tells the wait till you see this next panel.
The people in the behind the bars in the prison.
Yeah, so he tells the guys he has locked up in the jail cell to shut up, you idiots. And the look on his face is so, just shut up, you idiots. Yeah. Look at
they
his eyes.
It just so it's his eyes, and they take away the friendly cheeks and his big grin. So that, and they he's all red. It's just like
it all
a red,
red
panel.
Oh, this artist.
So, yeah, first he's like, oh, you know, come in, son, come in. And then you get this little flash of anger. And then he offers, this is a recurring thing that I loved, is he offers a guy a cigarette, but then when he goes to light it, he doesn't quite light it.
And blows the match out.
Waves the match out. Like he doesn't realize he didn't light it. And then the guy goes and looks for some matches, and the matchbox is empty.
Yeah,
guy is constantly trying to, so throughout this comic, he's constantly trying to light his cigarette, but it never gets accomplished.
Yeah, and the reason he didn't light the match is he's telling our hero, we're going to find out later that he's our hero, I guess, the protagonist.
Well, you can tell he's the main character, I guess, but just from the art.
Yeah, he's preoccupied with telling him about how he's got the map all prepped up for him and we're ready for you and we're going to give you a 10-minute head start and our main character says map and then this always suckers me in. I love maps. I love looking at maps, and then he lays out this map and it's like
it looks like a great old map.
It's a realistic treasure map of some sort. And he's all smiles. The sheriff is all smiles. There's that the no match in the match book, you know, like, he goes to light his own cigarette, and of course there's no matches. And then there's the map, and he says, and the sheriff, the setup is, we're going to give you a 10-minute head start, and here's where you have to go. If you can get to
Eagle Mountain, you'll be safe. You're here now. He's like, safe? So you see the guy, he's like very confused. He doesn't really know what's going on. And it was here that when I was reading it, I started thinking like, this is like a dream. Like, this comic is like being in a dream. Like, you know, when you're that feeling when you're in a dream and you're at a place and everything's going on, but you don't really know what's going on. Like, you know, like you're being chased, but you don't know who's chasing you or why you're running, or like you have to find a thing, but you don't know what the thing is.
It's a fever dream.
It felt just like that, where like you're at a party, but you're like, what's the party for? What am I doing here? Someone shows you a map. You're like, well, okay, what's going on?
The whole book is what's going on.
Is like, what's going on? But in a very classic dream style.
Yeah.
And so the guy gives him the map, and then he gives almost no explanation other than you'll have a 10-minute head start, which is a great hook. He has a map, and he has a 10-minute head start.
It's scary almost, right? When you're reading it's got some scary. Ominousness
to it.
You're like, 10-minute head start? 10-minute head start? How, like, do the other people have cars?
Yeah, like, what am I ahead of? You know, and where am I going, and what am I going for? So all those hooks are laid just brilliantly by giving you as little information as possible. And then even better, so then someone says, it's time. And then the sheriff says, oh, and one more thing.
Don't trust the map.
So they give you the littlest amount of information.
Oh, and the best hooks, right? They give you the littlest information, and they take it all away from you. And then this scene where he walks out, and like, how many people can be, like, the entire town is there, all flag waving, all hands in the air. They are so excited about our hero walking across that line and doing this. Now he realizes
the celebration's for him.
Nope.
Because he's doing this thing. Whatever this thing is.
I love it.
I really like these balloons.
Where are the balloons?
Let's go to the next page.
Oh.
There's like a girl blowing him a kiss, and a kid comes up with his photo and is like asking for an autograph or something.
Oh, no, this is one of my favorites. On the next page, the like Hawaiian girl gives him a lei around the neck, kisses him, and then the little tiny girl gives him a bouquet of flowers and and a top hatted mustache man gives him the key, like gives him this massive key.
Big key, like a key to the city. And I'm like, are these things, like, what's the key for? You know, that's my first question. And they give him like they also give him a knapsack full of stuff, like supplies.
Oh yeah, everything you're going to need is in the bag. And then this is also, I thought,
which is another great hook, because you're like, what could he need and what's in the bag?
What could he need and what's in the bag? And then like that like just the top panel of the going away celebration, they open the streets for him. All the balloons are flying. There's press. Like, there's a bunch of people. There's a little old lady with a good luck sign. And I love this. I love
there's how. There's an airplane that, like, spells out good luck in the sky.
I love how many people are there and that they don't do repeat face. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, this many people are there. This many people.
They don't
people
even do repeat art style.
No, they don't.
Like, on one of them, it's like sketched out. One of them is like cartoon. One of them, it's like charcoal drawing. You know, sometimes they're in color, sometimes they're not. Sometimes he's in color, sometimes, you know, he blends in, sometimes he doesn't. Sometimes they're blue.
The style of dress. Sometimes they're cowboy, like the sheriff is a cowboy, straight up cowboy, and then there's a gal with like a poodle skirt. Like, it makes
and
no sense.
The guy has like a giant top hat. It's like you can't. It's like when you're in a dream and the characters aren't. You're like, wait, I thought you were my dad. Now you're like my teacher.
Yeah.
But you still kind of are the same, you know, like, yeah, nothing's really taking purchase.
Oh, and then look at this, like that fade, the fade of the charcoaled people and behind, like, there's a really nice drawing of the sheriff toasting the guy on his way out, and then just the crowd fades away.
Mm-hmm.
They're not there anymore, and all that's there is this white line for him to like cross the line, and then, you got 10 minutes.
And there's a great little bubble amongst all the fanfare that just says, "Run, boy."
Yeah,
and just then like someone almost whispering in a crowd, but that's the thing he hears. 10 minutes, run.
And he does. Oh my god!
This is a cool running scene.
Oh yeah, it's 1, 2, 6 panels of running. There's that snake again. There's all kinds of lizards. All the lizards are always just sort of around, and the lizards look dumb. They don't look like real lizards, but they look like real lizards. I don't know how to explain that. They look a little softer than a real lizard would look.
And Larry, you said this is 6 panels, but I would almost also call it a splash page.
Oh sure,
a splash 2 page.
Yeah, I mean he is. Because
the panels go all the way across, and they're layered in a way that like you're seeing everything all at once.
Yeah,
especially because there's no dialogue.
Yeah, and you get the sense that he is trucking as hard as he's gonna. As fast as he can run, he's carrying this knapsack, the giant key, the bouquet of flowers. He's got the lei around his neck and the flower lei around his neck that's flapping in the wind, and he doesn't know why he's running.
No, or really where he's going.
Well, he's got the map, so he kind of has an idea of where he's going.
Yeah, but why? Or what he's doing. He's still carrying a key and a bouquet of flowers. So then he kind of is winded a little bit, and he looks back, and he can still see the town. And in the distance, he sees this really ominous-looking figure.
Looks like the Joker. Walking
slowly. Yeah, and he's done in like that charcoal style. Oh, I just love how this art, it has 4 different styles, and it's all just layered perfectly.
Yeah. Great coloring. And then he finally sits down he's like, what am I doing? He sits down, he starts to open up the knapsack. He discovers that he still has the cigarette.
I was curious about is what's he got in the knapsack. So he decides to sit down and do it. And
the first thing he pulls out, well, obviously he has that cigarette. He throws the lei away. He throws the bouquet of flowers away. And the whole time I'm thinking, no, I think you want those. I think you're going to want to eat those at some point.
You never know what's important. And then the first thing he pulls out is it's a stop sign.
Like, what a dumb thing to have in my backpack.
Yeah, a totally random thing you would pull out of a backpack in a dream. And then what else does he have, Larry?
Sound effects. He's got a wad of cash. Look like a whole lot of cash.
They're like $1 bills.
And then I didn't know what the fourth thing was, but we find out it's like a telescope. A
telescope type thing, yeah.
And a very small key.
A really small key and one match.
And one match.
Which is a great, and it's paneled out in a way that shows you each of those things. Like, it's almost like Larry's favorite kind of page where it's all of the different, what are we?
Oh, yeah, yeah. Like, all the tools that are available. Also, one of the things that we didn't mention is a phonograph record of sound effects.
Yeah.
What are you going to do with that in the desert? Oh, we're in the desert also. We're in the deep desert. This looks like Utah.
Yeah. And so each one of these things is now a hook of how's he going to use the sound effects record? How's he going to use the cash, the telescope, the key, the stop sign? And but first he's got to light a cigarette. And just as he's about to light it.
Pow. Now, it's
shot out of his hand.
I didn't quite get that it was shot out of his hand. I was like, did that just break by the force of him, popping it, but no, he has it lit, and then pow, next page, it is a series of pows, kapows, 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 kapows. He's getting shot at. He's
getting shot at by whoever this mysterious figure in the distance is, and they change to a new art style that we haven't really seen of this red and yellow.
Red on yellow on top of red on top of white on top of black. And then only red and yellow. I mean,
it's like you're in a different emotional state of fight or flight almost.
And he beats foot to some higher ground or some cover, doesn't get shot at, But I thought this was pretty cool. Look at that. Like, what's getting blown away there? Oh, he holds up the flowers.